We have ourselves a new tool in the workshop. If you guys missed it, there's a link to that video down below. But this new tool seems a little bit naked. It's time for us to give it some wooden pants. Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. In today's video, I'm going to be working a little bit more on the Auteur Laser Engraver. And this time, I need to give it some pants, as I said in the intro, for whatever reason, but a customized, secure base for it to live on, but also be a lot more portable for me to throw it around where I need to in my shop. I have the laser engraver mounted to a sheet of half-inch Baltic birch plywood, and this gives me a nice stable base for it to sit upon, but most importantly, makes this thing portable. What I'm going to do next is actually drill holes on the top of this board so that I can hang this whole thing on the wall when I don't use it. I'll probably be using it quite a bit, but in a small workshop, it's really handy to be able to hang stuff out of the way or put tools up when you don't need them. This thing is light enough and small enough that I can easily do that. So I'm gonna drill some holes through this board with my Forstner bit, and then we'll find a spot to hang it on the wall, to then quickly get it off the wall and start making some more stuff with it. I really like that thing hanging up there. It is very nice that it's so lightweight that it can just live right there. And when I need it, I can get it down off the wall and use it and make stuff with it and then put it back up. It's really handy having it on the wall, especially in my small workshop where any flat surface tends to get surface itis. Case in point, CNC table is holding a backpack and a couple other things right now. That's okay. That's because I'm using my laptop for the laser engraver here in a minute. Yeah, So anytime that I can get a tool off of a flat surface and put it up to where it won't collect things on its own is really handy. I like having a lot of the tools here in front. That way, you know, it's kind of a cool backdrop, but it's also easy to see what I have, where it is. I can grab it, use it, and then put it back where it goes. With the simple plywood board and mounting system squared away, we can now get the laser engraver off the wall, put it here on my workbench, plug it up, hook it up, because I want to make myself a custom maker board grid thing to engrave on that board itself to make it a lot easier to line up projects and things as I make them, and also Samcraft it a little bit. Let's go. Alright, I've got my laptop hooked up to the laser engraver and everything itself, and I have Lightburn open here. I want to go ahead and disclaimer, I am in no way a Lightburnologist. I do not know this program very well at all, so I may take the long way around my elbow to my ear, or whatever the saying is, but what I'm going to do is design out a grid on here on Lightburn with probably my logo in the middle, at least that's what I'm thinking so far. And I'm gonna make it and then have it burn it into this board on the laser engraver. I want to have a grid so that it's a lot easier to align projects. It's a lot easier to get repetitive or repeatability with placement of burns or things. And I think it's really gonna be helpful for both my sanity and the quality of projects that I can produce from this machine, especially, you know, things such as, you know, sets of four for customized items, or just maybe one thing, just over and over and over, batch it out. I definitely think having the grid on my backer board, or I guess in this case, it's a waste board, that would be really helpful. So I'm gonna venture into Lightburn. Like I said, I am no Lightburnologist or expert. So yeah, watch a guy who's only used the program for 2 days, muddle through it and get something figured out. What I've done is draw a very crude and rudimentary crosshairs of sorts. I'm gonna go ahead and get some scrap wood and burn it into it to see if it's the correct size and everything. Also pin down my settings and light burn with the machine so that it is dark enough to use, but not too dark to be too dark. So let's go ahead and play around some scrap wood here and find out if it's the right size. And then when we got that all set, we can move ahead with making this thing a little more fancier. So I'm loading up my scrap piece here. I'm going to need to refocus the laser. So for that, you raise the little plastic piece up, and then using this little rod that comes with the machine, you're basically undoing the clamp so it slides up and down and spacing it just that distance off the top of your material. So that is done. And you can fold back down the little shield. We'll hop back into Lightburn here. And we'll go ahead and click on the fire to show us where the laser is. And then hold down the shift key, clicking on frame. Whew, that's a small one. But let's go ahead and make it. Let's see what it looks like. That was super quick. It is not very large, but I don't know. It's not too bad either. I may try increasing the size just a little bit here. What if it's a 1 inch? Let's just try this. We'll do a shift frame to see what we're working with. All right, and let's go ahead and do this one. That's pretty nice. I don't know, I kind of like the big squares. It makes me wonder if I'm really gonna be working with something that small or if that is good enough. Well, I'm going to tinker around the Lightburn a little bit longer, and when I have my design pinned down, I will yak at you guys then. I decided on a 1-inch size for my crosshairs. I really think it gives me a nice usable size. This right here, easy to see. And then I mean, it's got a 1/4-inch increment inside that box. I don't think I'm gonna be getting two more exact for that. If I am, I can always put a jig on this backer board, waist board, and just use that. In reality, it's probably also what I might do in the future anyway. All right, I think what I need to do now is use some more of this scrap wood here and play around with the speeds and the power of the laser to where it's not going to make it solid black as far as burning the logo. I want it to move fast enough to where it really just shows it, and that's about it. I have played around and I have found the settings that I like. You can see it right here on this example. I wanted to make sure that the crosshairs are still dominant. That's the whole point and what I really need on this board. But I also wanted my logo to be there, but not be solid black. So I ended up going with a 4,000 millimeter per minute, 100% laser setting. And then I set the line interval to be 0.5 millimeters. 0.5 millimeter gave me enough space so that it's not solid black, but also was tight enough to where you can still see what this is. Well, with that done, my settings pinned down, I think we're ready to put this thing all together and actually burn the backer board. Minutes later, and I have myself a really cool customized wasteboard for the laser engraver. I think it turned out really, really good. I'm really pleased with all of it, with the exception of my OCD doesn't like it's not perfectly centered, but whatever. That's how it's going to be, so just get over it. So now with my wasteboard done, I can go ahead and start pumping out some projects or some things on this laser engraver. If you have any ideas, something you want me to try or make or anything of the sort, let me know. Leave me a comment down below. Help me get creative and think outside the box on some cool stuff to do with this thing. If you have any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Otherwise, I'll see you guys next time in the workshop.